Hello dear buddies, welcome back to my channel Easy English. Well, today we gonna talk about the differences between spoken English and written English, spoken English and broken English, and last one is spoken English and communicative English. And if you don't know about spoken, written, broken and communicative English, so you can check out my previous video. I have shared my previous video's link in description. So without wasting any more time, let's start today's lesson. Firstly, we gonna look at the differences between spoken and written English. Well, the first point is about the medium. In spoken English, conversation is the medium. And in written English, writing is the medium. Now move to the second point, which is about grammatical rules. Well, in spoken English, grammatical rules are not strictly followed. But in written English, grammatical rules are strictly followed. Before move to the third one, I would like to explain this point. Look at the example. Suppose a person asks you, "What is your name?" You reply that, "I myself Astha." But if you write the same question's answer, so you have to write, "My name is Astha." Now compare these answers. Look at the first one. Here is no verb when you are speaking that, "I myself Astha." But when you write, there exists a verb, that is is. So keep in mind that in spoken English, grammatical rules are not strictly followed. But in written English, grammatical rules are strictly followed. Now move to the third one, that is, in spoken English, fluency is most wanted. But in written English, good English is most wanted. And now move to the last difference between spoken and written English, and that is about tense. In spoken English, mainly 6 forms of tenses are followed, and they are given below: present indefinite, present continuous, present perfect, past indefinite, past continuous, and future indefinite. But in written English, all the 12 forms of tenses are followed. And this was all about the differences between spoken and written English. And now it is the time to know about the differences between spoken and broken English. So let's move on. There is only one difference between spoken and broken English. So let's talk about it. Spoken English is fluent English, but broken English is halting or limping English. If you can't understand, I am giving you a demo. You just listen it carefully. Hi friends, good morning. Today I have the pleasure to say a few words on my school. You know, school is my second home. Well, to me, it's a nest of love, nest of education. Here I spend all the time in joy with my friends. Our miss and teachers are so caring and loving. Friends, discipline and knowledge we all need. I have got it from my search school. So to me, my school, my guide, my pride. Hello friends, good morning. Today I have the pleasure to say a few words on my school. You know that school is my second home. Well, to me it's a nest of love, nest of education. So I hope that all of you can understand the difference between spoken and broken English. When you are speaking fluent English, that is spoken. But if your English isn't fluent, that becomes broken English. So what kind of a speaker is you? Spoken or broken? Well, now move to the last one. So here we are going to know about the differences between spoken and communicative English. Well, the first one difference is about the skill. Well, in spoken English, there are two skills, listening skill and speaking skill. But in communicative English, there are four skills, reading and listening, listening and reading, writing and speaking, speaking and writing. In communicative English, the main motto is communication. I told you in the previous video that in communicative English, you can communicate to a person via a phone, SMS, letter, whatever you can. But in spoken English, you only have to speak and listen. Now move to the second and last one. We use spoken English only for conversation, but we use communicative English for communication. So this was all about the differences between spoken and communicative English. So for today, that's all. See you in my next video. To get my new videos, subscribe my channel.